What's going on, guys? Clinton Troy 7 here, or Johnny. Today, I am finally starting our new series of Life is Strange. I was going to start two new series of Life is Strange and The Last of Us, since The Last of Us is like a great game, and I can't wait for the second one, but I kind of got bored one day, and I already started playing The Last of Us, so I'm only like a mission into it, though, but I could restart and then do a new series if you guys want, but right now, we're going to do a little something different. It's gonna be Life is Strange. I'm just saying now that if I don't talk that much throughout this series, that's because I'm not like other playthroughs where I know what to say and stuff, so it's kind of new to me. And when I'm playing a game, I like to enjoy it, so I don't want to talk over the game as much because I want you guys to enjoy it through your computer and stuff as much as I'm enjoying it as playing it. So I don't want to bombard you guys with my talking over the gameplay. So let's just get started. Alright. Music. So far, the music's pretty good. Nice and calming. Pretty relaxing. And I'm probably not going to read all this stuff that pops up through the game and stuff because I don't feel like reading. If you guys want to read it, you guys can just pause the video and read it because I'm too much of a terrible reader to actually read it. Alright, so we're starting off pretty weird. I mean, in the middle of nowhere, in what looks to be maybe like a little walking trail or something with like a lighthouse, but it is very stormy tonight. So I guess there's like, oh yeah, look at that, there's a tornado. That is massive. Look at the winds and the freaking ocean. Oh, there's some houses down there. I guess we're by a city. Oh, that's crazy. If this ever happened to me, dude, I'd be shitting my pants.
Holy shit. So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream. Bueller? Weird.
Diane Arbus.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear
there
the class
go,
laughing
Victoria.
At me now.
Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces.
I haven't kept totally up with my journal as much as I should. If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
She saw humanity as tortured, right?
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
Seriously though,
but I like it old school.
Any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation.
I do love my analog camera.
Any one of you could do that.
I should take a quick picture now.
Isn't that?
We're about to take a selfie in the middle of class, just like that.
Shh, shh, shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. Hey guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Even her school books are gift-wrapped. Of course, Victoria has to have... I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Holy crap, $5,300. For just a silly camera.
This might make a cool shot.
I just worked so hard on the shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed by your work. I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event, and I want to represent Blackwell Academy.
You have just by participating.
We take some pretty cool photos.
By putting yourself out there in the world, now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road.
This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around... Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
I had my moment in the camera eye, and everybody should have that chance.
Oh, totally. Right? I only want to share whatever gifts I have with the world.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max. You're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
You can never escape the lighthouse from the beginning. Whoa, Mr. Jefferson is not messing around with that monster. He probably paid 20 grand for that camera. I bet he gets pristine digital images. But I still dig my little instant camera. Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy. Here's the poster for the contest. Mr. Jefferson really expects me to enter. Why? I don't know if I'm ready for my 15 minutes of infamy.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the real world.
Cute.
Hot.
send you a special picture.
She's trying to send nudies.
She plays it so
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
I'm liking it. So far, I'm liking the game.
Evan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool. Alyssa is always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people.
To all of you, American girls, it's sad to imagine.
There's Taylor, always waiting for Victoria.
American
I think that's Courtney. She's such a slave to Taylor and Victoria. Ah, the science room. Here's the portal to Warren's brain. These missing persons posters are popping up everywhere. I hate having everybody see inside my locker. Yes, this poster must stop bullies dead in their tracks. That's Dana talking to... I think his name is Justin. Dana is on my floor, too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. Stella is always deep in her notes. She didn't come to Blackwell to mess around. I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. And he's a Vortex Club member. Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type.
There's a lot of posters around here.
There's Hayden, another Vortex Club bro, but he's actually not an ass. Figures Juliet would be dating Zachary, jocks sucked up in the Vortex Club. There's Juliet from my dorm, yet another Vortex Club disciple. He's cute. I like skater boys. Too bad they don't like me.
That's when I fly.
Miss Grant is a great science teacher. Principal doesn't come out of his office much. God, Samuel is such a weirdo. But I kinda like that about him. Blackwell sure takes its swimming seriously. But otters are cute. Go otters. Empty. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me. Now who would bother to write that crap? I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. OK.
okay, girl. You don't get a photo op like this every day.
Why is this dude in the girls' bathroom? What the fuck?
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family. Not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever
tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand, and then I was back here.
These pieces of time can frame us in our.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow, from color to.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now.
Shit.
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane. Can I actually reverse time?
Go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
I did it.
Can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the
human
condition
time machine.
In black and white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her
images. Keep it together, Max.
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
this. Of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so I can go back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry. I feel sick. May I be excused?
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
I'm again. 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 I'm
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please...
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework. I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography...
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Yes, Victoria.
I wish I could go talk to Mr. Jefferson about what's going on. Excuse me. Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy. Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come
don't
on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to
I
do!
I need a hammer to break
so
it open!
Sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Oh. Holy shit, I can't let this happen! If I can reverse time again,
nobody
I can help her.
Would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
I need a hammer to break it open!
Shit! People trying
oh, I have the hammer.
No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
Principal Wells always looks so distracted. I can never figure out what he's thinking. Does he hate?
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You could always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class.
Just
tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet.
Nice sunny day.
Hey, Hayden.
There she is, the retro selfie master.
That's me, all right. You look relaxed as usual, Hayden.
It's a skill one cultivates at Blackwell, especially when one represents the Vortex Club. Not to boast.
What the hell is the Vortex Club anyway? Seems so elitist.
Only if you're not cool enough to get in, and it doesn't hurt your resume.
If you say so.
I do. But you should actually come hang with us one night, then you wouldn't be so inclined to gossip.
You mean hang with a Vortex Club? That sounds like a setup to a horrible prank.
Chillax, paranoia girl. We're not that desperate for fun. We know how to do that on our own.
It seems weird to think about partying with all those Rachel Amber posters up.
You're high. Rachel used to hang out with us too. She was a blast. Smart, not bitchy like, you know.
So you knew Rachel Amber?
I knew she liked to party. Fun to be around. Oh, yeah, and she was hot.
What do you think happened to her?
Whatever happens to people who disappear without a trace.
Did Victoria like Rachel? She seems like the jealous type.
Don't think you know Victoria so well. She respected Rachel, even if she didn't act like it.
Rachel was actually a member of the Vortex Club?
No. Rachel was like her own club. She was actually too cool for us. And I'll deny I ever said that.
Do you really want Nathan Prescott to represent?
Oh, please. Nathan is like everybody's voodoo doll. Kill the rich kid. He's all right and a fun guy to hang with. Fuck the haters.
He seems genuinely unstable to me.
Nate has his extreme moments, but don't we all?
I don't know yet, Hayden. Let's talk later, Hayden.
Bye, Max. Now, I have to get my chemical on and study. We should get you and Dana out one night.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
Is that really yours? Is that even legal?
Of course. Nobody knows about it yet.
Isn't it considered a weapon of war?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
Alright, well, she's a bitch.
What a complicated name for such a tiny drone. Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive. This is where the otters perform their aquatic magic.
Laser flip.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the max. Come to Thrash?
Thrash? You mean stage diving, or...
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Hold up, fool.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the...
I came to nose slide, but I'd love to see somebody do a tree flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah, I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Go for a tree flip.
Tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action.
A little nut tap.
That's one of his famous shots. I love how it captures the moment. Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition. But would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Mattson, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
David Mattson doesn't need another excuse to harass students here.
Max, this isn't about personalities. This is about protecting civil rights and our school's legacy of freedom. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
You know a lot about Blackwell for being the science teacher.
Science is history, Max. And I have a secret wish to teach local lore and legends. There's a lot of unique facts about this you might really enjoy discovering. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Absolutely. I don't mind security, but not pure surveillance.
I knew you were my favorite new student at Blackwell for a good reason.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Oh. Hi, Max.
How are you doing?
Fantastic. I'm by myself reading Chiclet. Pretty soon I'll be bonding with Victoria at the Vortex Club.
I think you're better off reading Chiclet.
Good point. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your wave hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose.
No.
So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bone ass out of my way.
Nice, bro.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
Sweet.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
No.
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
She looks like a pissed off wet cat, and she's still stylish.
Okay. Nice, bro.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Nice, bro.
Gloria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
No!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I drive.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches. That would be nice, if the water blossomed Victoria into a nicer person. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
We'll be nice.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
Nice, bro.
It was. But there'll be another.
No.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max.
Awesome.
I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
Oh, dude.
You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
Okay.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
Victoria probably played me. Room 217? No way in hell am I ever going in here.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
Go, Miss Grant. Not sure if I will, though. I'm a loser. Is this a Vortex Club or a Victoria Club initiation? Truly pathetic. Juliet, extreme reporter. Dane is still a cheerleader at heart. Looks like nobody won this TP war. There's nothing left but ghosts. At least that's an alarm from this century. Okay, this is just mean and stupid. How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say. Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. It's such a pretty guitar. I need to play it more.
Mother texted us. Hi honey, your principal sent me an email saying that he is concerned about your attitude and behavior, that you are not fitting in well and hiding in your dorm. I know it's hard to be away from home, even if you were grown up now, but you are here to change the world with your camera. Please call me soon to chat. We miss you, XXOO Mommy. So they seem a little bit concerned.
It's not exactly pretty and pink, but no shits are given. I like my wardrobe. I love that Mom sent me a fat box of chocolate coconut bites for my birthday. And slipped in a $200 gift certificate. She sure knows how to make a sad birthday happy. Hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood. Would Man Ray call them selfie portraits? Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball. The Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall. Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot. That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle. That was a good hockey game and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. Crossing.